Well, I mean, Jack, I'll tell you a story about Jack. It's a really fast story. When we were in Reno preparing for the movie, and so Sean stayed on in Reno to scout, and Jack and I flew back on a private plane together. And so here I am, one of my heroes, and I said, Jack, I said, five easy pieces, The Shining, Last Detail, Carnal Knowledge, King of Marvin Gardens. And, you know, he's sitting there, and we're in this private plane, it's humming and everything like this. And I'm like this young kid, and he looked at me and goes, like I've always said, kid, I don't make movies. I make classics.
When I won my Academy Award, he was there. He won, this was his third Academy Award. We're standing backstage because they're just about to take you to the press conference. And he goes, you know, Robbo, now I have one for every decade. You bastard.
Jack Nicholson, I did a movie with Jack called Blood and Wine a couple of years ago. And we were walking, this sums up Jack in one line, his whole character in one line. We were just walking along towards the set, and then suddenly the cry went up, the sun's going, hurry up, hurry up. And everybody started rushing around.
Yeah, they're losing the light.
They're losing the light. They said, it's getting dark, it won't match. And then I started to run. And Jack said, don't run. They'll know it's us who's late. Which sums him up,
yeah,
you know?
Figured out.
He just figured it all out. I was running.
He explained his lifestyle, which isn't anything like my lifestyle.
Have you ever spent any social time with Jack? I think this guy could be
punishing. I spend social time with Jack. The thing to do if you spend social time with Jack is to wear very heavy boots.
Why is that?
Because the women trample all over you. It's true. You want to wear old clothes and heavy boots. Because you'll be sitting in a club, and Jack is sitting there, and these women will come, and they just sort of push you out of the way.
Oh, really?
I don't know what it is. I mean, Jack is, you know, he's not a young man, you know.
No.
There's hope for us all yet, I believe. But, I mean, the girls, they go nuts over him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He's also single and rich, which helps.
He's a big shot.
Jack Nicholson tried to steal your girlfriend. Right. Is this true? Is this a
You know
story?
Laura Flynn Boyle, right?
I was there. I had a front row seat for all this.
Oh, okay.
It was amazing.
It's a really wonderful story.
I went to a party and...
Well, first of all, this is like when Jack was Jack.
Oh,
yeah. I mean, this is like Lakers, court seat, Batman, Joker.
Oscars, yeah.
This is...
So, I was Squirty Spade. So
we
already see the future outcome. But we were there, we were dating, and we went to this party, and we were smoking a spliff. He said, you want to smoke a dupe? So, sure, why not? Why would you ever say
Jack
no?
Jack asks, you got to say
absolutely.
Yes. Do anything. So smoke it up. Halfway through, he goes, hey, Spade, I think I'm going to ask out your girlfriend. I go, huh? I really get it. I go, all right. And then later she goes, what are you doing, dude? You don't even put up a fight for me. I go, well, first of all, I go, are you going to go out with him? I don't know. And plus, he outranks me. He's cooler, he's richer, he's better looking. Like, I get how it works. It's okay. You're going to do what you're going to do. I can't. And she goes, dude, he's worse than Trump. He's gross. I would never. I go, okay. So, because I guess, I don't know. So immediately she started dating him after that.
And then, me and a couple other models who could act came out here and met casting directors. And my agent happened to know Jack Nicholson really well.
Oh.
So, can you tell where this is going? Tell where this is going, right?
Well, yeah.
So, every night, somehow or other, we ended up having dinner with Jack Nicholson. And then one day he invited the three of us over for lunch and made tuna fish sandwiches and milk. it was like a very weird experience. Anyway, so we come home one day and there's a message. Gina Davis called Jack Nicholson. I was like, oh my God. So my roommate, look at this. Call Jack. I'm saving this forever. This is unbelievable. Mr. Nicholson, yes, hello. This is Gina Davis. You called me. And he says, hey, Gina. So when's it gonna happen? I was like, sorry, what? You know what I'm talking about. Come on, when's it gonna happen? I said, oh, well, Mr. Nicholson, I'm afraid you have the wrong idea. Come on, I'll send a car. Come on over. Come on over.
We can see it. I hope you got a fan here.
No politics,
Jack, no?
George. What about
if you want to talk politics, we can.
Such a beautiful job.
Thank you.
Don't make you crush it.
Yeah, you're being really rude.
Good to see you.
I love Jimmy.
Oh my God, thank you. I loved all your movies. Oh really? Do I look like a new girl, bro?
I thought about it.
Oh my God. Is he still here?
I'll be waiting.
Oh my God. I need a rear view mirror.
Well, I was going to ask you, what are you going to remember about tonight? I think it is. Had you met him before?
No.
Remember this moment from backstage at last year's Oscars?
Have you spoken to him since?
No, he sent me flowers and a bottle of Cristal.
Oh?
And a note that said, missing you already.
Really?
Yeah, not to brag.
This was right after.
I should have probably like kept that a secret so it could just be between me and Jack.
Did you ever run in with Jack Nicholson, the ultimate Lakers fan?
Yeah, well, I was at the Lakers game. I think it was like game six in Los Angeles. Dane Cook and I were sitting courtside. We like had made it our business, our like second job to go to all these games and really rally for our team. And all of a sudden, we're courtside. I'm wearing my Celtics gear. I'm screaming, going crazy. And I get booted. These guys come and pull us out of courtside. I'm like, what is going on? So we end up in the chairman's lounge at halftime, and I'm like hiding in this like hallway, and all of a sudden Jack Nicholson comes out of the bathroom and he's like, hey, 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 hey. And I'm like, and I thought really quickly, I'm like, oh my God, what if he goes, I see they moved your seat. I'm like, he got me kicked out. I heard later he called Jerry Buzz and they had me removed.
No, basically he said, bring her to me. That's what he did. He's what they're looking. That one, bring her to me.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
This was in the tabloids.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I have to ask you about this. This is a picture. And yeah. This article was all about how Jack Nicholson and you go to the Lakers game together, yes, and yes. The Lakers are getting beat, so it's that you guys left early before the end of the game.
Yes.
And it was sort of saying, like, hey, you know, you guys walked out on the Lakers.
Lakers were having a dry spell, but it's not like I have anything in that decision. You know what I mean?
Well, what happened?
Nicholson says, all right, so we're losing. Lakers are losing by, like, 19. And Jack says, something like 6 minutes left. I go, yeah. And he goes, 19 points. They're going to lose. I go, well, you know, they could come back. He's like, well, I don't, something like, the Lakers have to score 20, and OKC has to score none. I go, yeah. He goes, we're going. And I go, yeah. No, maybe we should stick around, I think. Maybe finish it up. He goes, we're leaving. So, you know, I'm trying to talk him out, and then all of a sudden, you know, Nicholson leaves and gets up, and so I, you know, I'm not going to leave him stranded. I go, yeah, let's go, baby, and out we go, and I see even Lakers are like, Jack? Oh!